One of our very favorite Wild About Turkey workshop activities is called Staying Alive. And if you've registered for this online turkey workshop, then you will receive a Wild About Turkeys guide produced by the National Wild Turkey Federation. This guide can also be purchased from them directly. We're going to show the activity now and show some of the items that you'll need to get together if you're interested in doing this activity in your classroom. We can assure you this activity is fun and memorable. In fact, it's a great way to reinforce what we've been learning about turkey adaptations. So let's get started. I have gathered some items for my turkey trunk for the Staying Alive activity. These are items you might be able to find in your garage or in your house. Maybe they're lurking in the basement. And if not, you can go to your nearest thrift store, hardware store, or even your dollar store to find some of the items that you'll need for this activity. First thing you need to do is pick someone in your classroom, or maybe it's yourself, to be the turkey. And Lori's agreed to be our turkey today, and we're going to dress her up with some of these items to represent the adaptations that turkeys have to survive on the landscape. So let's get started with some of the caruncles. So if you have looked at some of the other activities or lessons, you've learned that caruncles are the colorful skin and bumps and lumps that are on the turkey's head and around the neck that are colored red and blue. And that is what the males use during mating season to show off to the girlfriends. Let's get you your colorful head. And all your colorful caruncles for around your neck. Perfect. Now, every self-respecting tom turkey also has a beard. These beards are actually modified feathers, and the bigger or older the turkey, the longer the beard. So we're gonna make you a very impressive tom turkey.
I'm very old.
Yes. I did not say that. Now, turkeys also have feathers. In fact, they have almost 5,000 feathers on their bodies. So we're going to use this downy vest to represent the thick feathers that they carry on their body, and they use for warmth and protection. But we also know that those turkey feathers are camouflaged, help them camouflage into their surroundings so that they can hide from predators. So now we have a camouflaged turkey.
Can't see me.
Now, all turkeys have toenails on their feet, and they use those toenails for scratching in the dirt or on the ground to reveal seeds or insects. And so we have to make sure that our turkey has the appropriate footwear for finding food. Male turkeys also have spurs. Now, they don't exactly look like this. They are a kind of a bony projection off the back of their leg that they use for defense or for scuffling with other turkeys and kind of showing off how big and strong they are. One thing that any turkey hunter will tell you is turkeys have great eyesight. That's why turkey hunters are always dressed in camouflage, and when they're hunting, they have to hold very still so they're not seen by turkeys. So we've got to give our turkey some great eyesight and a beak for eating their food. And I attached a red balloon on that beak to act as the snood. That's what the name of that piece of skin, that red skin that flips over the beak. It's called a snood. You're looking really good.
I'm feeling really good.
Turkeys have a gizzard. And it's part of their digestive tract, and it's a muscular structure that grinds up the food that they take in so that they can digest it. So you could use a chopper like this one to represent a gizzard. You could also use a cheese grater, something to represent that the food is being chopped up in some way. So I'm going to give you your gizzard. And besides needing feathers to fly, birds also need hollow bones. That makes them lightweight so that they can take off. So we're going to give you some hollow bones so that you will be able to fly. You're going to hold your gizzard. Perfect. And of course, our turkey needs his voice. And so it's always a good idea to let them gobble before they strut their stuff.